around the world, as much in that sound of inspired proud feelings. But where he does all that circumnavigation conduct, only through numberless perils to the very point whence we started, where those that we left behind secure were all the time before us. But as the strange captain was in the act of putting his trumpet to his mouth, it somehow fell from his hand into the sea, and the wind now rising amain, he in vain strove to make himself heard without it. Meantime, his ship was still increasing the distance between. For this world an endless plain, by sailing eastward we could forever reach new distances, and discover sights sweet and strange, than they were promised in the voyage. But in pursuit of those far mysteries we dream of, or in tormented chase of that demon phantom, that sometime or other swims before all human hearts, while chasing such over this round globe, they either lead us on barren mazes or midway leave us whelmed. The cabin compass is called the telltale, because without going to the compass at the helm, the captain while below can inform himself of the course of the ship. It almost seemed as though he would have lowered a boat to board the stranger, had not the threatening wind forbade. Taking advantage of his windward position, he again seized his trumpet, and knowing by our aspect that the stranger vessel was a Nantucketer, shortly bound home, he loudly hailed, "Ahoy there, this is the Pequod, bound round the world. Tell them to address all future letters to the Pacific Ocean."
Mate at my side, bones at our feet, we will own everything at sea. We won't stop, we've a master fleet, adjust the mast for Emmons speed. Prepare to board, take what you please, everything else will have to sink. And leave no one alive, because there's a price upon our heads.